ये लाइफ
सो
Hello everybody, we have six people live right now. We'll wait for some three or four, we'll wait for 10 people to join and we'll go ahead with the answers.
So yeah, please start leaving your comments. How did you find the set? Was it easy, moderate, difficult? Let's hear from the participants.
Manish Agarwal says looking forward for the answer. Whoever is online, just can you all just say hi so that we'll know who is online, who's live. Sophia says hi.
Yeah, there are 11 people.
We have 12 people.
So,
I
yeah,
think
we
you
are
can
waiting
start
for
with the answers.
A few.
Yeah, maybe we have 12 people. I think we can start with the answers.
All right.
So everyone can comment your answers in the comment section now. In the live chat, you can comment your answers. We'll just take out your name and say whether it's correct or not. Okay, the first question was Aristichophis dash is a venomous viper species endemic to the deserts of Pakistan, Iran, Afghanistan, and some parts of India. It is named after a person who demarcated a controversial international boundary of India. Fill in the blank or identify the person. So this was the first question. Let's wait for some answers in the live chat comment section. Vishal says Radcliffe.
This is one of those you know, you see on Discovery. So you can see the comment.
Maybe your voice is breaking. Maybe you switch off your other device. Your voice is breaking. Vishal says Radcliffe.
Yeah.
Andrew says McMahon line. Siddharth says Radcliffe. Sunil says McMahon. It's not actually McMahon. It's
Mark also says
McMahon.
About the quiz was today. You're very sorry.
Manish Agarwal
We're glad you
says Radcliffe. Okay, we got enough answers. The answer is, of course, McMahon or McMahoney. McMahoney is a species name and McMahon is a person. That was question number one. Question number two.
So, yeah, we showed this particular picture. This was the official mascot of a men's hockey tournament. This was actually 2018 Men's World Cup, Hockey World Cup. So we asked what was the name of the species and the official name, which was kind of interconnected, derived from the animal name. So let's hear the answers for this. Many, many have answered this. I think this was one of the most answered questions. Yeah. Yes, Ashish is correct. So is Ramakrishna Ranganathan. Yeah, Vishal got it right. So yeah, let's reveal the answers. Many have written this correctly. So Ollie. For Olive Ridley turtle, we all know the Bhubaneswar was the hint here. Odisha is known as this nesting, it's known for the nesting activities of Olive Ridley turtle. And interestingly, that's coinciding with our quiz. It's going on right now in on the beaches of Odisha. So that was the correct answer.
And question number three, for the first time in the history of the world, a young girl climbed into a tree one day, a princess, and after having what she described as a most thrilling experience, she climbed down from the tree, next day a queen. God bless her. These were the words by a man who served as a bodyguard of Princess Elizabeth in 1952. Which famous conservationist closely associated with India are we talking about? A very famous conservationist closely associated with India who comes to our mind first. Siddharth says Corbett, Manas says Corbett, Jim Corbett, Balaji says Jim Corbett, Ashish says Rudyard Kipling, nice guess. Sunil says Jim Corbett. So yeah, I've got enough answers. The answer is, of course, Jim Corbett. Jim Corbett National Park is named after him. It's Jim Corbett. Next question, number four. Maybe?
Yeah, it's still loading for me. Just give me a second. Yeah, we asked about the small deer, which derives its common name. Yeah, which derives its name from a Dutch word for small deer. And we also played a video clipping where you can find this animal making an alarm sound when threatened. So quite a simple question. I was very happy that many people got this right. The correct answer for this is Munjak, and then the nickname, alternative given to name given to it is the barking deer, because it sounds very similar to a dog's bark. That's why it's called a barking deer. Indian Munjak, or simply the Munjak was the Dutch root word that we were looking for. That's the correct answer, complete answer.
Yeah, so Munjak and barking deer is the answer.
Yeah, question many have five. Given the local names as well. So we asked about the Dutch version of it, the Dutch root term. So the local names, though, are correct. We can't consider that. Okay.
During the selection process in 1963, X almost won the title, but it lost for the reason being it might be misspelled to Y. So the throne in the picture shares its name with Y. So what is X and Y? So yeah, Y is of course peacock. In the picture, you can see is peacock throne of Mughals, which was looted by Nadir Shah. And then the X is Great Indian Bustard, of course. So the answer is X is Great Indian Bustard and Y is peacock.
I think this is in general among quizzes, this is a well-known trivia. Need not be a wildlife enthusiast. We all have heard this story. So we thought let's ask a few easy questions that everybody can get.
Peacock throne is something we see in our test books a lot.
Not the big, the Great Bustard story.
The Great Bustard story is
it's a lot different. Yeah. Next question. So we asked about the biennial report, quite a sitter. That's published by WWF every 2 years. So that is the Living Planet report. So that's how we got some answers. Yeah, correct.
Yeah, this is Living Planet report. This is not just limited to India. This is a global report, and also the report is also launched in India. So yeah,
great, you got it from many of them actually. Yeah,
many of them got it right. Question number seven, while launching the results of Indian Tiger Census in 2019, PM Modi referred to two Bollywood movies, X and Y. X indicates meager number of tigers in 2010, while Y indicates that country became a safe place for the animal to be alive. What are the two movies we are referring to here? The animal is, of course, Tiger Census. Tiger, what two movies are we talking about? We got some answers. Vishal says Ek Tha Tiger, Tiger Zinda Hai. Yeah, of course, it's Ek Tha Tiger and Tiger Zinda Hai.
I think this is one question everybody got right. I didn't see any wrong answers for this. I didn't see any other movie names. All the quizzers who took part today got this question right.
I saw one answer as Mai Zinda Hoon. That's also a decent guess, but yeah, this is about tiger. So Tiger, Ek Tha Tiger and Tiger Zinda Hai.
All right.
Yeah, question number eight.
So yeah, we asked about this salt lake that is named after a goddess who represents vegetarian diet in India. So vegetarian diet, we call it as, you know, what is the Hindi or Indian term for it? So you could have derived a hint from that. So on which goddess was it being? Okay, the most frequent answer was Chilika, which was not the correct answer. It's not the Chilika lake. Okay, we'll give you a hint. The goddess is called Shakambhari after Shakahar. The goddess is the tutelary goddess of the Chauhan Rajputs. So now derive the name from that. This one lake, all of you have definitely seen some pictures because this is basically the wintering area for the pink flamingos. So if you have seen many flamingos in a wetland, which is of India, that is definitely this particular wetland we are talking about. No, yes, few of them got it right. Naveen got it right. I think so did Manasdeep.
Purushar got it right.
Though it's one of the most frequent answers, that's incorrect. Vishal also got it right. So yeah, that's the correct answer. Sambhar Lake was the correct answer we were looking for. From Shakambhari, the name was derived.
And yeah. Question number nine. Diclofenac is a drug that was extensively used to treat cattle fevers and inflammations in the 80s. As an indirect consequence of this, a certain species revered by a very rich community in India saw 99% of its population deplete in last 40 years. Which community and animal are we talking about? Yeah, no one got this wrong.
Yes, this is also one of the most answered questions.
Yes.
Naveen gets it right. Shrunga gets it right. Many. Balaji Deshpande, and there is Sarvesh Prabhu, Vishal, Arundhati. All of them have got it right. So it was a two-part question. We were looking for the animal and then the community as well.
It's not Balaji Deshpande. It's Balaji Dandapan.
Sorry.
Okay. So it's vulture and Parsis.
Vulture and Parsis was the correct answer for that.
Question number 10.
So yeah, this sanctuary in Kodagu. So what is so unique about this? What is special about this particular sanctuary? We told it was initially started in 55 acres and later extended to 300 acres. All of this had nothing to do with the answer. What was so unique about this sanctuary? That was the question. Also one of the most answered questions in today's quiz. This is India's first and also currently the only private sanctuary in India. Owned by a couple who have come and settled down in Kodagu. They bought this barren land and developed a sanctuary in that. Is the correct answer. Yes, Naveen, Siddharth, Sunil, Sarvesh, Balaji, all of them have got it right.
And question number 11. In picture is K. Munshi, well-known freedom fighter. However, his well-known, his greatest contribution for the environment in India is during his term as a minister. He planted a tree at Rajghat in the first week of July and thus started tradition in India. Which tradition are we talking about? Sarvesh is Van Mahotsav, Andrew says Van Mahotsav. We got all the correct answers. Shrunga is Van Mahotsav. Yeah, this is of course Van Mahotsav.
Some of you answered it as Environment Day, which is not the correct answer. So basically, you have not scored any points if you have answered it as Environment Day. That was not the correct answer. Maybe Forest Day would have made more sense if you really wanted to translate it. Because 5th of June is considered World Environment Day, we didn't consider that particular answer. All right. A train connecting Kolkata to Kathgodam, named after an endangered animal species, the Hindi name for it. We said the blank was indicative as well. Many answered this correctly. Let's hear some answers in the comments. What is the name of the expose is the question.
Harida Tampal ma'am says thank you Vishnu for doing this. So for everyone who's watching there, Harida Tampal ma'am is a president of Hyderabad zone of WWF India. So she was the one who came forward to support us through on behalf of WWF, and they're giving all the prizes today.
So yeah, Sham got it right. So did Sunil and Shrunga. That's the correct answer. Vishal got it right. The answer is, yeah, she's the state director. A correction there. She's not the president. She's the state director. Farida ma'am. All right. So yeah, Sunil, Rao, Sham, all of them have got it right. The correct answer was Bhag Express. For Tiger, it's okay. Simply called it Bhag Express.
Next question number 13. In Persian, Azad means free. The scientific name of which tree native to India, high in medicinal value, is derived from the Persian words literally meaning the free tree of India. It's a tree which we can find everywhere in India. Which tree are we talking about? And this is one question which 95% of the participants got it right.
I think the medicinal value was the giveaway here.
Yeah.
Would also like to hear what exactly like made you guys answer this question, because I didn't see a single wrong answer for this. I think that was the giveaway here when we said medicinal.
Yeah, one Vishal even gave the scientific name Azad Dikita Indica.
Yeah.
So this is of course Neem and Azad Dikita Indica. And next question, question number 14.
Yeah, we asked about a really interesting species that builds that such nests on the floor, on the forest floor. So we normally don't see many nests on the floor. So which is this really unique species that that is, I said, endemic to western parts of India and some other parts of India? Let's hear some answers. He's right. Wish Sham is right. Naveen is right. Vishesh got it right. So did Arundhati. Siddharth, okay. I didn't see that comment. Yeah. Okay,
yeah,
all of them got correct.
Cobra.
Yeah, a very, very unique reptile when it from the world of snakes. It's a very unique reptile. There are many qualities that sets this apart. So about the nesting habit of the king cobras, among the 3,000 odd snake species in the entire world, this is the only snake that builds a nest. So that sets it apart. And also, yeah, one of the most feared animals, which is wrongly so, because it hardly bites a human. If you see the statistics, it's very, very rarely bites a human. It's for a reason. It's considered one of the most intelligent snakes. And the sight is very sharp. The sense of smell is very strong. Hence, the animal is always an alert and very rarely confronts a human. So, yeah, that's the correct answer. King cobra, all of them have got it right.
And question number 15, Eriovixia dash, a spider species discovered in Karnataka, is named after a world-famous fictional character who was the original owner of this certain artifact. Fill in the blank, or maybe give the name of the owner who owns a certain artifact.
So many, many of them have answered as Harry Potter, which is not the correct answer, because the question was very clear. The original owner of a certain artifact was the question. So Harry Potter, yeah, Naveen,
we
that's not the correct
many
answer.
Many answers as Harry Potter hat, Hogwarts
Dumbledore
hat, Dumbledore.
Kind of very, very interesting answers. From Lord of the Rings to Harry Potter to many other fiction. Okay. Yeah, this is the sorting hat, which originally belonged to Godric Gryffindor, is the right answer. So Gryffindory or Gryffindor was the answer we were looking for. Naveen has changed his answer from Harry Potter to Sorting Hat to Gryffindor. I hope you have written the keyword that we were looking for, which is Gryffindor. Is the correct answer. Sunil got it right. So did Vishal and Vishesh as well.
Yeah, question number 16.
Yeah, Madras Sappers. We told you about this engineering corps of the Indian Army. I think they're some 2.5 century old wing of the Indian Army. So, like I said, their contribution in different battles is denoted by a different animal. I think there was one Egyptian war they fought, which has a sphinx as their insignia. And there is the Asai, which has elephant. And which one was this, is the question. I didn't see a single right answer for this question. Not a single right answer for this question, though many of you got the battle correct. This was 1948. I told it in the video. which was also the hint. And the La part was very visible. So many got the battle right, which is the Zojila. Battle of Zojila was the correct answer. But which animal was the question? Not Markhor. Markhor has this corkscrew kind of a horn, which is very evident. So this is not Markhor. And that's largely Pakistan and very less Kashmir. Which animal is this? I thought you guys would have gone and browsed it later on. I don't see any correct answers. Not ram, not the Kashmir stag. No, not Markhor, not the Himalayan thar. I think this is one question they got partly right and the other part remained unsolved, unanswered. This is the Himalayan ibex. Quite simple as that. Himalayan ibex was the answer we were looking for, and the Battle of Zojila is the right answer. Yes, moving on.
Question number 17. Seen in picture is Rajput king who did something in 1948 which had a major consequence, negative consequence on Indian wildlife. So what did he do? What is his claim to fame was the question. So we often keep on seeing in the news that some animal came into the population on the village or something, but
we avoided the keywords like names to a great extent possible so that people can't Google. But yeah, many answered this correctly. The royal was Ramanuj Pratap Singh Dio of Korea.
Yeah, so we don't have any cheetah alive in India right now. So we keep on seeing the news that cheetah came into the village. That's a leopard. People consider it as cheetah. We don't have any cheetahs alive in India. The last cheetah was killed in 1948 by this man.
And Vishnu, I think it's the only animal declared extinct in India in the last 100 years or so. So yes, that's one additional. Yeah.
And so we're trying to reintroduce it from Iran, and Iran is asking for lions in exchange of cheetahs. So we don't want to give away lions.
Yeah, he can be seen here with the last three Asiatic cheetahs that he shot at somewhere in Madhya Pradesh, if I'm not wrong.
Yes.
This was in 1948. And years later, it was declared extinct. Yeah, we asked about this culinary ingredient, which is this. Many got it right. I was surprised to see so many correct answers because this was one question I thought may go unsolved by. Okay, Farida ma'am added a bit to the cheetah question. She says, sad part is we do not have the habitats suitable to bring them back. So it's not just about the exchange part where you know, we are not willing to give away the lions. Habitat loss was also one of the reasons for extinction. And currently there is no correct habitat in India to support a cheetah.
I think
population.
We need a very large area for cheetahs to be alive. I think I'm not sure.
All right, we have received many correct answers. Sarvesh got it right. Okay. Yeah, lichens or lichens are the correct answer. So they call it, I think, Kalpusi, Kuchi in Telugu and Kalluhu in Kannada. I think basically words that translates to stone flower. In many Indian languages. So the correct answer we were looking for, this term we were looking for was the lichens or the lichens.
And question number 19, simply look at the picture and you're seeing something maybe?
No. Go on. There is a delay in the stream, so I'm getting it a little bit.
Okay. So in the picture, you can see an organism. Let's look at the shape of it. And what organism are we talking about? It's the only one in the world by Government of India at Lakshadweep. A conservation center is there, named after Dr. K.K. Mohammad Koya. Which species is this? Which, name the animal, name the species.
It's popular seafood also.
Yeah, so yeah, we got enough answers. Sea cucumber. Sea cucumber is the answer, or cucumber. Sea cucumber is the answer. The blanks are not indicative in this question. Question number 20.
Size was not indicative, actually. The number of terms were. Okay, we asked about the strange occurrence which happens in a part of India in September in this very small stretch between 6:30 to 9 p.m. Every year. It keeps happening, and many, many ornithologists and many scientists have tried to study the cause for this, but it's largely unsolved, as we say here. But there are some theories which explains why the disorientation might have happened. So these are a couple of theories regarding it. So we asked what particular, which strange occurrence. So yeah, many have got it right. Sarvesh, Vishal, Balaji, Naveen, everybody got it right. So basically the key terms we were looking for was mass bird suicide. If you have mentioned this, even if you have mentioned Jatinga, that is enough. So that's the correct answer. Every year birds come and die here. Actually, they say the dying is actually man-made. I mean, it's a induced thing. Basically, they get disoriented and the villagers put on the lights to attract the birds. So when they come, because they're disoriented, they come and hit the buildings and trees, and that's how they fall down. And then the villagers kill the birds. So most of these deaths is because of that. Now that many people have went there and tried to create awareness, it has come down by like 40%, they say. So that was the correct answer.
And question number 21, it is believed that Kashmir region was once a huge lake occupied by Jalod Bawa. Then Vishnu takes an incarnation in Varaha as Varaha and kills him and liberates this place. So which city in Kashmir derives its name because of this story? A quite controversial place which is often in use because of militancy there or some military activities there. Yeah, of course, it's Baramulla, and Rahamulla. We got answers from Manas, Sunil, Sarvesh, Andrew, and Balaji. It's Baramulla or Varahamulla. Varahamulla is an old name, and Baramulla is English corruption of it. Or
this was one of the English three notable answers. If you knew basic Sanskrit words for the word rule. Root, you would have cracked this easily. Many yes. Answered this correctly. Yeah.
Yeah. Question 22.
Yeah, the we asked about this animal from the eastern part of India, which is so enmeshed in the local culture. They sing rhymes about it, and every kid in Assam might have either heard or learned this rhyme as a child. So, which is this animal? A primate that is locally called as a hollow bandar, a hollow monkey. So which is this? And the name is derived from this particular sound that it makes. We also played a audio clipping here. A really interesting sound it makes. Naveen got this correct. Vishal even give the additional trivia. He actually told what's the unique distinction held by this among the 26 primates in India. Correct, this is the only ape found in India, that is the Hulog Gibbon. That's the correct answer. Hulog Gibbon is the correct answer. So yeah,
so that was the last question. Thank you everyone for participating. Yeah, and we'll announce the top four people who scored the top four. The first top scorer is Arun TP, is a top scorer. Renuka Mani is a second, stands second. Abhijit Balachinder stands third. And Vinod Hariharan stands fourth.
Vishnu, there are some queries in the comments. Somebody is asking about the number of participants. And Mana says many wildlife experts here. So yeah, we were also equally surprised to see so many correct answers. It was a very pleasant surprise. Can you reveal the number, total participation, Vishnu? Somebody is asking for it.
Yeah, so the quiz was taken by 65 members submitted answers at the end of around 8:27. We closed the form around 8:27 and we got 65 answers until then.
We had over 100 registrations and...
We had over 120 registrations. But only 65 people submitted the answer at the end of our quiz. That is 8:27, we closed the form. At the time, we had only 65 answers.
When the scores and winners will be declared? Anurag is asking that.
Yeah, the winners will be declared. You'll get a mail. Everyone is connected to mail. Probably tomorrow you'll get a mail. We're almost done with this course. We'll just recheck them. And I think everyone got the certificates. You'll get the results in next few hours or tomorrow morning. You'll get the results. And WWF.
This course won't be declared. He is asking, no, this course won't be declared. Thank you, Deepa. She says, interesting questions. Thank you. Many of them are saying, yeah, Vishal says, lovely set of questions. Great quiz. Thank you so much. Thank you, all of you.
Yeah, and WWF will contact you for the prizes, the top 10 and top 3. You'll be contacted by WWF for the prizes soon in the next week, next working week. Thank you all. Good night. Goodbye. And please subscribe to TACON.